MLB The Show is your home for postseason baseball. It's Game 4 of the National League Championship Series between the LA Dodgers and the San Diego Padres. Hi again, everyone. Matt Vaskirjian. Welcome to our special postseason coverage of Baseball on the Show. With me is Mark DeRosa and Dan Plesac. And Dan, lots of storylines here as we approach the start of Game 4.
Well, I think this series has played out exactly how we expected it to. At 2-1, it's been tightly contested back and forth. We've got two teams worthy of being here, and I think this will go at least 6 games before it's all said and done.
The postseason is officially in full swing. Lineups and first pitch coming up next. Mike Clevinger will be on the mound for Game 4. Dan, any thoughts?
Hey, at first glance, he's not your ordinary-looking pitcher. He's got that long flow going, those long locks. But I'll tell you what, he has a big arm, has a good fastball, good hard-breaking stuff to go along with it. He's been a very solid pitcher for the last few seasons.
And now here is Mookie Betts. He'll get us started in this one under the lights. Is on to begin the ball game.
Wow, you know he's not happy with that call. When it crossed the plate, it sure looked like a strike to me. Seemed to catch a ton of the plate. That's a tough way to give up a walk, but he's got to put it behind him now.
Into the box, Corey Seager. 2 balls and 2 strikes to Corey Seager. Swung on and missed for the first down.
Fooled him just enough with that pitch to get him to go around, according to the umpire. Sometimes it can be really tough for these big, strong guys because once they're committed to swinging, it's hard for them to slow their swings down, and that appeared to be the case there.
That's in there on the outer half. 1-2 now. Fastball blew it right by him, and there are two.
Talk about blowing it by a guy. Jeez, I mean, that fastball was way behind him when the swing came through the zone. I have to think he was looking for something off speed, and he just couldn't pull the trigger on that fastball.
Over to first, and the runner back in standing. At the plate, Cody Bellinger pulled toward right center field. Back goes Grisham. He's there to make the play, and that'll retire the side. One left for LA. Dodgers scoreless, Padres coming to bat. It's the battle for Southern California bragging rights, and it's on the show. Julio Urias is the man on the mound for the 4th game of the series. Dan Plesac, what do you got?
Hey, Matty V, this ought to be exciting. This is one of the top young pitchers in the game right now. He keeps getting better. He keeps learning. And if he continues at this pace, this guy has a chance to be one of the more reliable pitchers in the game.
So here is Trent Grisham. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. Two balls and two strikes now. The 2-2. Thank you. fastball is right by him as he swings and misses for the first out of the inning.
Up next is Fernando Tatis Jr.
In past meetings with Julio Urias, he's 0 for 4. Ball and two strikes now.
Hey, if he's going to execute that curveball, and that's the first one of the day, if he's going to execute it like that, be on the lookout for that one. That's going to be a big pitch for him today.
And he lays off the pitch outside as they draw even at 2-2. The pitch. Swing and a miss on the fastball that time, out number two. And with two away now, let's give you a look at what's happening in the American League Championship Series, as they've got a good matchup going on over there as well. And in steps Manny Machado. No one aboard for him, and two gone here in the first. Bases are empty here with two men out. One and two now as that one's fouled off.
Hey, this guy's dialed in right now. Two strikeouts and still working ahead. This is going to be a tough test for the offense.
One-two is laid off for ball two.
It's going to be a long day if he executes like this, punching tickets right out of the gate.
And just a masterful job of pitching here as he strikes out the side in order. Three up, three down for San Diego. We are still scoreless. Will Smith. They'll get us started in the top of the second. Now the 3-2 pitch. That smoked, but right into the shift. On the first, and there's one gone here to start the second.
That is good. The first baseman, Max Muncy.
Next up is Max Muncy. Something has to give. Here's the payoff pitch. Swing and a blooper down the right field line.
Cronenworth.
Pitch charge out there, and he stays with it for the second out. So two out, nobody on, and that'll bring up A.J. Pollock. And he fires a fastball now for a called strike two. That fastball was a lively one. You could hear the pop of the glove all the way up here.
Hey, I admit I'm a little biased. There's nothing better than that pop of a glove on a good fastball. Looking forward to hearing a lot more of that pop the rest of this one.
And it's fouled away. 2-2 one more time.
3-2.
Well, you don't see it all that often, but this might be a good time for a 3-2 change. If he can locate it, it's nearly impossible to hit.
High fly ball out to straightaway center. Back goes Grisham. He gets there to make the catch, and that ends the inning. Dodgers down in order. We'll go to the bottom of the second. No score. Four-hole hitter Eric Hosmer. He's set to lead off the home half of the second. 2-2. Reaches down and hits this one on the ground to short. And there's one down now.
That is good. The left fielder. Tommy. Pham.
Next to the plate for the Padres, Tommy Pham. Still looking for our first hit in the ballgame. Swing and a ground ball to third. Scooped up. And the off-balance throw gets him. Nice play for the out.
That is good.
Next up is Will Myers. Trying to make something happen with two gone in the bottom of the second. And that misses 2-1. Two out, nobody on. And he fouls this one off. Even at two balls and two strikes, here's the pitch. Got him swinging as he runs the fastball by him to end the inning. Padres down in order. We'll move to the third with no score. And now, Gavin Lux, as we are all set to begin the third inning in this one. One pitch. Looped out toward third. And this will be no problem over the third. And there's the first out. So here's the Dodgers pitcher, Julio Urías. Here it comes on 1-1. Now a fastball gets the upper part of the zone for strike two.
The offense better get it going right here, because they certainly can tell from their dugout this guy is carrying himself with a presence out on the mound. He's got feel for all his pitches.
So he racks up the swinging strikeout on the breaking ball. Julio Urías goes down for out number two in the top half. Stepping in now, Mookie Betts. And the inning goes away in unceremonious fashion on a swing and a miss at a ball way outside the strike zone. 1-2-3 go the Dodgers. Home half of the third coming up. No score. And at the plate is Jake Cronenworth. Is taken for ball two.
I know he missed with a fastball right there, but this guy's arsenal, you can't figure out what he's trying to do. He's got a lot of different directions he can go in right here.
2-2. Full count now. 3-2.
Well, that sets up a big pitch right here, Matt, because you don't want to lose the leadoff guy in a scoreless game. It's tough to work around the leadoff walk.
Fastball called, strike three, and there's the first out of the inning.
Batting it. The catcher.
One out now in the San Diego third, and that brings up Austin Nola. Both teams so far yet to crack the hit column. Fastball,
Fastball just inside. The 2-1 pitch. Just off the outside that time, laid off for a ball.
3-ball count right now. This looks like the best chance of getting a base runner on so far.
The 3-1 pitch. Too high, and that cost him ball four.
They haven't been able to register a hit against this guy, but at least they have a base runner here. We'll see if that leads to something.
Clevenger.
So now the pitcher, Mike Clevenger. This is a textbook sacrifice situation, so let's see if that's the call. And they'll try to stay out of the double play here as he lays this one down. And he'll just beat the throw to second. He's in there.
Well, he took a risk with the decision to throw to second instead of taking the sure out at first. Not sure if someone was yelling for him to go to second, but we know now it was the wrong call.
In now, Trent Grisham. He pulls this one into right. Betts is there, two down. Next to dig in, Fernando Tatis Jr. struck out in his last trip to the plate.
Yeah, and kind of shocked he got blown away with a fastball. You could tell he was late on that one. And we'll see if he tries to cheat to something this AB.
Pulls this one in the air out to left. Pollock has a read on it, and that ends the inning. Padres leave a pair. We'll head to the fourth, still scoreless. All set for the start of the fourth. And up next, the former All-Star shortstop, Corey Seager.
Still a big bagel in that hit column. And this is where the frustration can start setting in on a team if they're not careful. It's never a good feeling when you know the guy out there on the mound is completely shutting you down.
Now an off-speed pitch well inside, and it forces him to bounce away from danger. Here's a big swing and a miss on the fastball, 2-2. Dirt, so he's working full now at 3-2.
Not a time to fool around right now on a 3-2 count with the middle part of the order coming up. Expect a good pitch to swing at.
A swing and a drive sent out toward the gap. Meyer is going back. Gone to lead off the inning. A solo home run for Corey Seager. His second home run of the series. And the Dodgers strike first, 1-0.
Hey, listen, there's an old adage in baseball that solo home runs won't kill you. This is one of the top hitters in that lineup. So a home run, a solo home run right here, it's not the end of the world.
Now, Justin Turner. And not a real good cut at that slider, and he's behind 1-2.
Yeah, guys, he's got so much respect for this guy's fastball, you could tell he was out in front on that slider. I think he goes to the well one more time with that pitch.
So he ran the fastball by him for the punch out. Well, Justin Turner becomes the first out of the inning.
That was good.
coming in now, Cody Bellinger. Not surprisingly here, this is on the ground to the right side. And he'll step on first himself for the out. So the bases are empty here with two gone. And that brings up Will Smith. One run, just one hit. No errors for the Dodgers thus far. To 1-2 now. Into the windup and the pitch. Now a fastball as he just reared up and let that one fly, and the inning is over. But the Dodgers are on the board first thanks to this solo home run. Bottom of the fourth coming up. It's now 1-0 LA. Ready to go in the bottom of the fourth. And stepping in, the long ball threat, Manny Machado. Hit hard on the ground towards second. He's right there. And quickly, there's one down to lead off the frame. So one gone in the inning now, and that'll bring in the first baseman, Eric Hosmer. Padres still with the big goose egg in the hit column thus far. Swing and a miss as they got him with the slider there, two away.
Classic slider down and away for the strikeout there. Not a whole lot to say about that pitch that hasn't been said a million times already. That's just a real tough pitch for a hitter to pick up out of a pitcher's hand, so they end up chasing when they're in protect mode.
At the plate now, Tommy Pham. A little behind on that swing, and now they'll try to shorten up maybe and protect the plate. Here comes the 1-2. Swing and a liner. And no trouble for him as he makes the catch to end the inning. Three up, three down for San Diego. They're on the short end of a 1-0 score. Bring up the left-handed hitter Max Muncy. Now the 1-1 pitch. Chopper to short. And the fifth inning will start with a ground out, one away. So bases are empty with one gone. And up next, the center fielder, A.J. Pollock. The 3-1. A swing and a miss, and that'll fill the count at 3-2.
What I love right there is just the freedom in that hack. He ain't trying to do anything but hit the baseball as far as he can.
And this is swung on and missed, so it's two up, two down to start the fifth.
Really good late bite on that slider right there. The best ones have that late action that just darts at the last minute. They're so tough to get the bat on, and when you've got that good slider going, it's a great strikeout pitch.
So now to the plate, Gavin Lux. And it's two balls and two strikes now.
That was a great hack right there. Timing was on point. Just sometimes you have bad bat barrel accuracy.
3-2 now. Bases are empty here with two men out. And he struck him out. His eighth punch out of the ballgame, and that one ends the inning. Dodgers down in order, but they lead it 1-0.
Welcome back to Arlington. Before we get much further, let's check in with Heidi.
Matt, I talked with San Diego's manager during the inning break about the Padres' offensive production to this point.
And he told me, overall, he's not happy with the at-bats they're putting together. They've only managed one base runner in this game, so it's easy to see why he said they haven't shown much fight today. He's hoping to see someone step up and find a way to get something going, though. This game isn't out of hand, so it remains to be seen if they can snap out of this funk and climb back into this one.
Thank you, Heidi. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. And coming forward, the veteran outfielder, Will Myers. Ready with the 1-1. Fouled away. Looking to punch him out again, the pitch. Breaking ball called just a bit low.
He might have to look for a different way to put this guy away on 2-2. He's already seen the curveball a couple of times, so he might be looking for it.
Myers puts a good swing on it. This one's carrying well to left. But a foul ball as it holds it 2-2. And now pitch on the way.
Hey, throwing the ball great up until this point. Don't want to allow a leadoff walk. Needs to just focus in on his mechanics right here.
Hit back toward the mound. And the Friars are into the hit column.
Nice execution right there, Dan. Kept his front shoulder in, kept his hands inside the baseball, and ripped the base hit up the middle.
And a good pitcher right there. You can't get discouraged. Sometimes, even when you make a good pitch, the ball's going to find a hole somewhere. That one right up the middle.
At the plate, Jake Cronenworth. Up in the zone for him, and he takes a called strike two.
Well, they've really had an answer for keeping him in check in this series. He's offered very little resistance with the bat in his hand so far.
Here comes the 1-2. Fouled off.
Hey, usually the second time through the order, you start seeing an incorporation of some more off-speed stuff. But this guy's locating and feeling really good about his fastball. Two back-to-back.
High fly ball out to straightaway center. Bellinger's under it. One away. Now so a runner at first with one out now. And that brings up Austin Nola. Here now the 2-2. Swung on and missed. He got him on strikes. Got him with a good high fastball there. Danny, we see a lot of that pitch in strikeout situations these days. What makes it so effective?
I think, Matt, what makes it such a tough pitch is you're changing eye levels. That fastball up looks so enticing to hit that you think you see that ball as a hitter. You think you can drive it, but it's really hard to get on top of that good, high, hard fastball.
Into the box, Mike Clevenger. They count now at 2-1. Myers is off of first with two away. Two and two.
Can't waste getting the leadoff runner on in this situation. Someone's got to bear down and get a big knock.
Two-two. Here's a pop-up now. Muncy has room in foul territory, and that ends the inning. One left for San Diego. They're down 1-0. So here now is the pitcher, Julio Urías. Opportunity to bat for himself with his guys up a run here in the sixth. Fastball, close, but he didn't get it. 2-1.
Certainly know he's not trying to work around the pitcher. Sometimes the hardest thing to do is to throw a strike to a guy that you know won't swing the bat.
Throw to first gets him, so the leadoff man's retired here to begin the sixth. So that'll bring in Mookie Betts. Just one hit apiece for both of these clubs. Swung on and missed.
Man, this guy's in a good groove right now. Seven straight retired. He's locked in.
Count still at 1-2. There's a drive high in the air and deep to left center field. And that is off the wall. Around second now and headed for third. The relay throw. Machado's tag is too late. He's in there with a triple.
Yeah, and you can see he was looking for a fastball all the way, and he jumps all over it, pulling it hard. And the second he dropped the bat, he was looking to stretch this thing as far as he could. Mission accomplished as he stands on third.
Corey Seager will stride in again, and you can bet he'd love to do again what he did back in the fourth. A solo home run here that's been the only long ball of the game so far. One out and a runner on third. Side 2-1. Some activity out in the bullpen now as a couple of left-handers begin to stir. Three and one is the count to the Dodgers shortstop.
I'd be real surprised if he goes back out away there on the mound. This is a count for a fastball challenge, and we'll see if he's ready for it in the box.
The 3-1 is in there for a full count now, 3-2.
That's three straight sliders in a row. I'd be shocked. I would be shocked if he went to that well a fourth time. I'd be looking heated.
Two. Swung on and driven to right, and no doubt about it. And goodbye. This one ain't coming back. So it's a two-run homer for Corey Seager. His second home run of the game, and the Dodgers have now taken a 3-0 lead.
Well, he's obviously very comfortable in the spotlight here. In the postseason, everything is amplified. Runs mean more, and every pitch counts, especially when you make a mistake as bad as this one. Missed his location, and he takes it out of here in a heartbeat.
To the plate now, Justin Turner. 2-1.
Couple strikeouts early in the game, but he's done a much better job at this at bat, trying to get ahead and put himself in a good hitter's count.
And it's fouled away. The 2-2.
Keep in mind, people, the longer the at bat, the higher the likelihood that this becomes his last inning.
Still only one out in the inning. Popped him up. Nola is right there. Two gone. Cody Bellinger at the plate now. It's been an 0-for-2 effort for him to this point.
Here's the 1-2 delivery. Pulled toward right center field. Grisham makes the catch to end the inning. But two come across to score in the inning courtesy of this two-run home run. Bottom of the sixth is straight ahead. It's now 3-0 Los Angeles. Bottom of the sixth inning now, and next will be a speed thread in the form of outfielder Trent Grisham. Ready to deal. Here's the 1-1. Swung on and missed. 1-2 now. And he'll try to entice him with the changeup here, but it dips below the knees. It's 2-2. Wanted that fastball to be, and it's 3-2 now.
No pitcher likes to take the count to 3-2, especially when you throw a non-competitive pitch like that on 2-2. That one wasn't even close.
Dribbled down the third baseline. The next 3-2. Swung on and missed. He got him on strikes.
He's been in total control out there tonight. Gets the leadoff guy with a strike out there, and it just seems like we've seen so many off-balance swings and weakly hit balls in this one.
Standing in now, Fernando Tatis Jr., and he fouls this one off. Loud contact there, but it's well fouled. Ready with the 1-2. Up to two balls and two strikes now.
Right guy, right spot. This is one of the better hitters in their lineup. Just the guy they want to see coming up now to get this inning going.
And this ball's pretty well struck high and deep to left field. And it's gone. Solo shot here to left, and the Padres are on the board. It's now a 3-1 game.
Wonder why some players make so much money, and there's your answer. The great ones find a way to rise to the occasion in the postseason, and he did right there.
Here comes the Dodger manager making his way toward the mound, and he's going to motion for his bullpen here. That'll do it for the starter tonight. He'll wind up lasting just one out into the sixth inning, but he'll leave with the lead and was effective in this one. Corey Knebel takes the mound as he's been called upon to pitch.
Number 46, Corey Knebel.
Now, Manny Machado takes a look at a changeup there, and it's a ball and two strikes now.
This is why the manager pencils these guys in the middle of the order. Big spot, time for them to get back in this game with a couple quality ABs.
And a fastball swung on and missed as they set him down for the second time here tonight.
Well, we'll see a lot of these power arms coming out of the bullpen in these days, but it doesn't make it any less impressive to me. I love watching guys come in and blow smoke right by guys.
stepping in now, Eric Hosmer. And this is swung on and missed. Might have even been a foul tip that's held on to, but either way, the side is retired. One scores in the inning, coming on this solo home run. The 5-6 and 7 hitters to start the 7th. It's the Dodgers 3 and the Padres 1. Keone Kella is on to pitch from the bullpen now to start inning number 7. New inning set to get underway, and next will be the speedy catcher, Will Smith. Now the 2-1 is a breaking ball that's taken for a ball.
Bobby Cox always used to say, I'm going to put you in positions to be successful. Well, against a modern-day bullpen, easier said than done. These guys are throwing flames from all arm angles.
And a good take there as they'll have a leadoff man aboard to start the 7th. It's ball 4.
You know, it takes a lot of discipline to watch a pitch like that go by, but on a 3-1 count, he had the luxury of being a little bit more selective up there. Good take, and a walk is the result.
And that'll bring up the versatile Max Muncy. No hits in 2 trips to the plate for him in the ballgame. We're in the 7th inning with a good finish brewing. 3-1 our score. Ball by him here. 1-2 now.
Hey guys, that fastball just registered 97 miles an hour. On a night like tonight where it's super cold out, if you don't get the head to that baseball right there and you get jammed, it's almost like getting stung by a pack of wasps.
Nice job on the mound to bounce back from the leadoff walk. Those are usually pretty costly, but that won't be the case this time after the 2-ball.
At the plate, A.J. Pollock. Little tardy on that swing as it's well wide of first. 2 out, nobody on. He got him. Lively fastball that time, and it puts it into the inning. Nothing doing for the Dodgers here, and the lead remains 3-1. Now we're going to have a conference at the home plate area, so it would appear that we'll see a double switch here. Joe Kelly will come on now, and he'll slide into the 7th spot in the lineup following the double switch. Chris Taylor is into the ballgame as well, as he'll slide into the pitcher's spot, hitting 9th now on the double switch. So now into the box is Tommy Pham. Third trip to the plate for him here tonight. 0-2 at this point. And now a curveball that's low and in the dirt for a ball. It's 2-1. Kelly has a good reputation for preventing the long ball. One swing can change the complexion of the ball game when you're coming in late, but he rarely lets that happen. Part of what makes him as effective as he is. 3-1 to the Padres left fielder.
Hey, leading off an inning in this situation, 3 balls on you. You have to know that a solo shot's not tying this game up. You have to find a way to get on base any way possible.
Ball strike, and that'll run it full.
Someone on this offense needs to take it upon themselves to have a quality AB and start the line moving again.
Into the corner and slicing foul. Quick enough that time, and he's lucky to get another chance. Count remains full. The next 3-2. And that misses ball 4 to lead off walk to start the home 7th.
Man, that's a tough one to swallow. You're hanging on to a slim lead, and the last thing you want to do is give up a leadoff walk. Seems like those are the ones that always come back to haunt you, so we'll see if that's the case here.
So the next to bat will be Will Myers, singled in his last at-bat.
Sometimes you got to be aggressive offensively, but sometimes you just let the pitcher dig his own grave. Patience and discipline seem to be the way to go right here.
One run, two hits, no errors in the ballgame for the Padres. Breaking pitch just bounces in front of the catcher.
Got to find a way to get back in the zone. I know you're in danger of losing both to walks, but certainly don't miss over the heart of the plate and have this guy gap run, or even worse, hit a two-run homer.
Now a move over to first, and he's back in standing. Set, here's the 3-1. Short, could this be two? The second for one, on to first, not in time as he just hits the bag ahead of the throw.
And kids, this is how you always go hard into second base. Could have been an easy double play ball, but the slide really impacts the throw to first, and they wind up only getting one out on the play. Good, aggressive, legal slide that time.
So now to the plate, Jake Cronenworth. And he lays off for a ball, 2-1. On the ground to the left side. Turner has it. One there. On to first, it's a double play. As their woes continue, the inning is over. That's how you roll it. 5-4-3. A double play sends us to break. Back with more of Game 4 on the show after this. Now the skipper's on his way out toward the home plate area, and I believe that means we're going to have a double switch here. Craig Stammen will come on now, and he'll slide into the seventh spot in the lineup following the double switch. Jurickson Profar will also come on now as he'll move into the pitcher's number 9 hold in the order here on that double switch. Ready to begin the 8th, and up next will be Gavin Lux. The 1-1 home. Padres are going to get something going out in the bullpen now as a left-hander has stood up to throw. The 2-1. Grounded down the third baseline. Throw on to first in time, so the leadoff man is set down to open up inning number 8. Next for the Dodgers, Chris Taylor. And he's getting his first plate appearance here in the 8th after entering off the bench just a little bit ago. Now here's the pitch. High in the air down the right field line. Myers is under it, 2 gone. Here's Mookie Betts. Tripled and scored in his last at bat, and we'll see what he does for a follow-up act here.
3-1. Swung on and missed. A full count now. Center base hit.
Dan, tell me how frustrating that is right there. He comes unglued the pitch before, and then he shortens his swing, and he's able to fight you off for a two-strike knock.
Sometimes, Mark, that's how you can get fooled as a pitcher. You see that previous pitch, you see that big swing, and you're expecting another big swing, but what does he do? He shortens it up and hits a bullet for a base hit.
Corey Seager coming to the plate again as we look back at his two home runs in the game so far, and the most recent back in the sixth inning. Betts, runner at first with two gone. Oh, and not an easy pitch to lay off of, but he did somehow, and he's got it to 3-1.
Every base runner in a close game like this really matters, so you can't afford to be giving out free passes this late.
Boy, look at that thing dart. It's full now, 3-2.
3-2, two out, runner on first. Lots of possible outcomes on this pitch.
Back up the middle and in for a base hit.
Yeah, that hard hit single right there, that's clean. 3-for-4, he's looking locked in.
Next up for Los Angeles, Justin Turner. In his last at-bat, he popped out in foul ground.
Yeah, this one's going to upset him for a little bit. You make the pitcher work the way he did right there, and that's the end result. That one sticks with you for a while.
Now the 1-1 pitch.
Has to be a challenge pitch coming up here. He probably doesn't want to flirt with loading the bases.
Now a swing and a miss at the hard sinker, and they're back to even 2-2. Eighth inning of this low scoring affair. 3-1 on score. Did a good job to shorten up and protect the plate, and he'll have another shot at it here. Here's one that misses inside, and the count's run full now, 3-2.
There's the heavy sinker right there. What makes that pitch so difficult to hit is not only does it change eye levels, it actually changes plane. You go to hit it at one position, and it's 6 to 8 inches dropping off the table and chasing your hands.
Sinker misses, ball.
These guys on defense are still within striking distance, but after that walk, one swing of the bat could really blow this thing wide open.
Your attention, please.
So they'll make a matchup move here and bring on a southpaw to face the left-handed hitter due up. Cody Bellinger will be the first one to greet him, and he'll bat in a big spot here. Bases loaded and two out in the inning. A little bit outside. 2-1.
It often becomes harder to hit the zone when the pressure starts to heat up.
Set and the 2-1. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Grisham is there as he makes the catch, and they'll tightrope out of danger as he strands the bases loaded. Dodgers leave them loaded, and it's still 3-1. Blake Treinen is on to pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the eighth. That'll bring up Austin Nola, 0 for 1 for him here in this one. The 2-1 is swung on and missed for strike number 2. Now action in the bullpen as their closer starts to get loose out there. Hit well on the ground to first. Reined in. And he'll take it to the bag himself for the out. So one man gone for the Friars in their half of the eighth. And Jurickson Profar will be the next to bat. The 1-1. One out, nobody on. Fouled away. And another foul ball. Fouled off.
Gotta believe that was a mislocation because it missed right down the middle. This guy's gonna have nightmares at the plate thinking about missing that one.
And he looks at a sinker for a called third strike, and now there are two gone. Now back to the top of the lineup, stepping in, Trent Grisham, who went down on strikes in his last at bat. One-one. High in the air and drifting out to shallow center. Seager trying to get there, but he won't get there. It falls in. The tag, and they'll get him at second. And with that, the side is retired. So no runs on one base hit, no errors, and no one left on. We're through eight full here in game four. Dodgers out in front, 3-1. Now, Will Smith. And a swing and a miss. Good pitch there for the first out here in the ninth.
It looked like this at bat had the makings of a leadoff walk when it started 3-0. So that's a good job not to give in and battle back to earn the strikeout. That's not always easy to do.
To the plate now, Max Muncy. And it's fouled away.
Well, somebody's sitting off speed right here. Only way he was late on that heater is he was expecting another changeup.
3-2, one more time. Swung on and missed, strike 3. Edwin Rios gets the call as a pinch hitter, and he'll get a chance with two out and the bases empty.
Number 43, Edwin Rios.
Bases are empty here with two men out. And they'll back him off a bit with a fastball in, but it's 3-1 now. He's got it. Two picks. He's up at the letters, but he gets the call. Strike 3. So they go quietly here in this half inning. 2, 3, and 4 set to kick off the bottom of the ninth. LA's on top, 3-1. Kenley Jansen comes out of the bullpen now to shut things down here in the ninth.
Number 74, Kenley
Fernando Tatis Jr. back at the plate now, and he's been the entire offense so far with the solo homer he hit earlier. The 2-1. slider, and that's hit on the ground towards second. And that's out number one. Here's Manny Machado now.
Third baseman, Manny Machado.
And he's way off balance with the swing there. Sharp ground ball to third. Throw on to first, and the Padres are down to their final out now.
Now back.
Eric Hosmer to the plate now. And he needs to make something happen. They're down to their final out here in the ninth. Two-run game, last of the ninth with two away. Very high, 2-1. Jansen's ready. Here comes the pitch. And this ball's in the air to left field, and this should do it. Catch is made, and the Dodgers are going to take a commanding 3-1 lead here in the series as this ball game is over.
Well, folks, that's what Kenley Jansen does. When he enters the game, the hopes of the other team, they usually just leave. Slams the door again right here.
This one, definitely a low-scoring affair as we get one last look at our final line score. Tonight's ball game comes to a close, 3-1 the final. The Dodgers take a 3-1 series lead and now look to clinch. Julio Urías earns the victory on the mound. So that'll do it for us. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plezak, Heidi Watney, and our entire crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, make your way over to the new website, theshow.com.
Here now is our final line score tonight. First for the victorious Dodgers, 3 runs, 5 hits, no errors. They left 4 men on base. For the Padres, 1 run on 3 hits, no errors. They left 4 men on base. Time of the ball game, 2 hours and 40 minutes. Thank you for joining us here this evening. We remind you to.